right there. This is walking and talking. There I'm practicing walking and talking in a bizarre condition. I'm just walking on the railroad and talking. Yeah, and I would like to summarize everything what I've said in first few videos. In the first video it was really difficult to focus on my thoughts. I was almost 50 or 60% focused on what I'm doing, means how I'm how I'm walking, and it was really difficult to talk about anything else. Then I started talking about art, metaphysics, about how you can improve your language just by talking about one thing all the time and trying to focus your attention on it, and continuing doing that for not just for a couple of days or weeks, but for months and years. Just imagine how good you may be at something if you dedicate yourself studying the subject and talking about it like every day for 15 minutes in a year. In my case, yeah, then I didn't say that in previous videos, but I thought about it between them. So the point is that in my case I'm talking a lot about thinking. Almost all, I think it's 70% of my content is devoted to thinking. And I'm trying to, it's like thinking aloud or talking about thinking, stream of consciousness, what's going on in your mind, how it feels when you are doing self-talk. So, and that's fun, but sometimes, I become overwhelmed with this topic and I feel that I want to take something else. So instead of talking about thinking, I need to find something else, like topics for speaking club, for example, and start developing my ideas about them. But it's the same as it's like when you consider thinking as your main subject, it's like you may, no matter what you are talking about, thinking is just, you are always doing thinking, and thinking makes you you may get aside all the time. So you're talking about egoism, then you ask yourself, why am I thinking about egoism? Why am I thinking that this or that is true? And eventually you just, talking about thinking for the next 15 minutes instead of talking about egoism. Yeah, and it's wow. And it's funny, I'm still on the railroad. I haven't fallen. I haven't fallen. I just jumped from one line to another, and it's fine. And yeah, sometimes you can do that if you don't feel. Yeah, exactly. It's so amazing. It's literally so amazing. Look, I was talking about, like, you may jump from, you decided to talk about egoism, and then you start talking about thinking. And it's like, and then you shifted to thinking, and the whole, the rest of your speech is about thinking. And the same thing here. It's like, I'm going on one line, and it's egoism, then I feel myself, uncertain, then I start shaking, and eventually I jump to the next line and start talking about thinking. It's like, yeah, it's like physical world is amazing. So, it's like, this analogy is so, it's so cool. I mean, wow. It's like when you understand something, so it's like an insight. So an insight, and yeah, this, I would like to practice this self-talk walking on the railroad more and more, because yeah, it's too amazing. I think I can achieve some not perfection, but I can do it not looking at the at the line, but looking at the camera all the time. It's like walking on the line, looking at the camera, talking about metaphysics or whatever it is. It's so brilliant. I mean, not brilliant, but it's amazing. It makes me feel so great. Okay, so what's next? Next, egoism. Yeah, it seems that today I don't have desire to talk about it, but I certainly would like to. Now I'm not just talking about the topic. I also write about it in Crazy Fish, in our group, and I make posts almost every day Like this week I'm doing it every day, and basically what I'm doing right now, it's like I'm trying to walk and talk and like brainstorming, but when I come home, I just start writing about the topic, and basically I use these ideas which I got from self-talk. So here I can, here I just try to find something, again just 15, 20, 30, 50 minutes, and then I spend next hour just trying to put my thoughts in order by using Russian language, by the way, because I think, yeah, my, when I gave up Russian language and started thinking in English all the time and writing in English and shifted my journal in English and everything in English, yeah, it made me a little bit, you know, not weird. Yeah, it reduced my happiness. It reduced my harmony, which I had before and which was so amazing. And I think I can manage two languages. I mean, yeah, it certainly was necessary to develop my English to the point when I can feel, you know, I can feel good while I'm using that language, while I'm talking. But now it seems that I already reached this point and I can continue developing my language, but I shouldn't spend all time on it. So I can just continue practicing Russian writing, because Russian is amazing. I mean, I feel so great. Ah! Whoa! I haven't fallen, I'm still here. I just jump from one to another and back. Yeah. Russian is amazing, and it means I start a new line, like new train of thoughts. Yeah, it's like now I feel myself as literally as train of thought. It's like I'm not this body, I'm not this man who's walking on the railroad. I'm just the process of thinking. And yeah. And it feels, great. Okay, so what's that? Egoism. Today I was talking a lot about this solipsism, and not a lot, but at least I mentioned it. Egoism, solipsism, determinism, how we perceive the world if you, if you stay on the position of determinism, when you think nobody can have free will, and all of it is just, it's just a movie which you watch. You are like, everything's a movie. You think, oh, movie is just actors playing the plot, and my life is not like that. I am a person, make decisions, responsible for them, feel remorse and guilty if I'm doing something wrong, or feel awesome and exciting when I'm doing something good and right. But actually there's nothing like that. It's like, no matter what you're doing, if you just decided, or no, if it's just, if it was predetermined that you'll feel great, and you may do whatever you like. No more any these negative feelings. But it's still impossible to get rid of all of them. So even if I, like, intellectually I understand it pretty well. But on a physical level, for example, if I follow this understanding, I would say that I must really feel amazing all the time. So no matter what, even if I'm saying some meaningless bullshit, I still must feel amazing. And yeah, I guess I can do that. I guess I can reach the point when no matter what I'm saying, I can just laugh at it. Because, well, if it's meaningless, let's make fun of myself and just, it's not necessary to be serious here. That's the point. When we speak English, like, look, most of the time people, when they learn language, they're so fucking serious. They think that mistakes are bad. When they make mistakes, they feel terrible. But actually, Yeah, you need to shift your perspective, shift your mind and say, oh, I make mistakes, that's funny. It doesn't, you know, implies that I'm a bad person, that I'm a stupid idiot. It's just, you know, my mistake, which doesn't exist since I don't make any decision. And it all is predetermined. You see how amazing it is to walk and talk on the railroad without falling for 15 minutes and also recording myself and, you know, yeah, and not being focused on this damn walking. It seems I'm already get used to, you know, the way how I'm walking, because at first it was so difficult just to keep, to hold the camera and, you know, maintain the balance. But now it's perfect. I can, you know, I can walk for for the whole hour. But yeah, it seems I need to stop here because I am getting away from my home and I need to go back. Yeah, maybe I can just turn. Wow. Okay, I failed. And it's just 11 minutes. Damn. I failed and it's just 11 minutes. I wanted to record the whole video without falling. But okay, that's, I can do it next time. Yeah, it's certainly a new experience for me since I haven't done it yet. I haven't walked and talked on the railroad and now I feel really great. And I guess I would like to repeat it. To repeat it and see, maybe it'll make me, you know, at least I feel excited and I feel, even if I'm talking about some, you know, sometimes, today I didn't talk about like meaningless stuff, I talk about whatever is important for me and whatever I like to discuss and whatever I like to share with you, but yeah, but when it felt, when I did some, no, when I didn't feel myself good, I was, well, there was a good excuse. I'm just walking on the railroad. Means that it's possible to say something unrelated. It's possible to lose your train of thoughts and, you know, to be distracted and, what? Yeah, it's fine. Well, again, railroad, new experience, egoism. Yeah, it seems I haven't said anything important to understand better what is egoism. But maybe it's not so important, because now I'm, you know, I'm doing this walking and talking, not, well, one, of course, one is only just one reason for doing walking and talking is to understand better the topic. But basically I'm doing it to get positive emotions, to get fun, to practice something new, to improve my thinking, to improve my, you know, language, to practice English. And since I talk about something else, who cares? It's like, again, I am this, if I'm an egoist and some kind of rational egoist, or, you know, if I take seriously psychological egoism, yeah, whatever I'm doing, it's just, there's only me who can judge it, who can evaluate it. And since there's only me, if I say it's good, it's good. If I say it's bad, it's bad. And I just need to stop saying that it's bad. Everything is good. Everything what I say is perfect. Everything what I say is excellent. And since I hold this belief and since I can convince myself that it's true, like, it's really, even if it's not true, it's eventually will lead to the point when I will be able to produce really amazing content, when I will be able to talk super, super smart. Why? Because, like, the point is that you need to feel really great while you are talking. And since you feel great, you may develop some amazing stuff. But if you feel guilty or bad, or if you are worried about your mistakes, you can get anywhere. You won't be able to, you know, to talk about something that really is important for you, because you are completely focused on, you see how fast I start talking after I get out of this damn railroad. It seems like completely different way of thinking. So then it was pretty hard, and I was focused on this dam, you know, to keep to maintain this walk. But now it seems my full attention is focused on whatever I'm saying, and it's much easier and I feel much better. Okay, but unfortunately I need to stop here because it's already 15 minutes. Yeah, and I would like to record more videos, but not today. So, see you later, bye.